Hello.
No radios, TVs, or any other form of communication with the outside world.
What? You make me wanna throw my picture out the window. Tell MCI to cut the phone calls. Break my leash so I can move. Cause you a bugaboo, a bugaboo. I won't
f***ing your face right now. You call me a f***ing face.
Hello, my name is Yamari. I'm gonna cover up the eyebrows that I cut off so it won't be weird. But my name is Yamari and I'm back, I guess, after like a year or two. I don't think anybody's gonna watch this video, but if you do, hey girl, I'm back because I'm bored and nobody's in the house with me. But today is just gonna be like a little mini vlog. I don't know, like I wanna be back on YouTube, but at the same time, I don't be having no ideas. So I don't do anything. But, so this is a little vlog. Get ready with me, come to Publix with me, come to CVS with me. I might take me a little bike ride, you feel me? But last time I tried to take a bike ride, I did not realize how much it took to ride a bike. And I was like, oh. Hey girl, I don't think you can do this. You out of shape, you breathing like you got asthma. We can't do this no more. So I never rode my bike again, and that was probably like 2 or 3 months ago. So yeah. Today I wanna get out the house and y'all are coming with me. So if you decide to watch this video, I hope you enjoy. You might be asking, hey, why did you cut your eyebrows off? Well, so there's this girl on Instagram, her name is Ugly Worldwide, and she, like, I've been thinking about cutting my eyebrows off for a while, right? And, cause they, like, when people do, like, makeup, like, they can draw whatever they want on their eyebrows. I'm gonna cover them back up cause this is weird, like, I'm really sharing this with y'all. But they can do whatever they want with their eyebrows, like, their face is a full canvas, they don't have to, like, draw over the same eyebrows every day, da 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 da, whatever. But I'm gonna put like her picture and like a lot of other makeup pictures right here while I'm talking. But yeah, so these people do really creative things. And I was like, oh my gosh, I wanna do creative things. So I cut off my eyebrows, I think Monday or Tuesday, I don't remember. Today is Saturday. Today is Saturday. And I don't know, I've just been experimenting ever since. But hey girl, or boy, or whatever you consider yourself, cause we accept everybody on here. I want you to know that I'm just going through life experimenting with everything, and you should too. Cause once it's over, man. And we don't wanna have no regrets, do we? Yeah, just, I guess, watch me get ready. I might make this like a little quirky YouTube, like aesthetic.
Brenda L. Green.
Man, y'all go and kick back. Back up, back up. I got this shit, man. Hello?
I just wanna chill and twist the lie. Catch stunts in my 745. You drive me crazy, shorty. I need to see you and feel you next to me. I provide everything you need and I like your smile. I don't wanna see you cry. Got some questions that I gotta ask, and I hope you can come up with the answers, baby.
Girl, it's easy to love me now. Would you love me if I was down and out? Would you still have love for me?
Dude, oh my gosh, I should make this like those videos. The L videos, like mornings with Luca Savage or mornings with Kim Kardashian or whatever. That's what I'm gonna make this like, okay? Probably not for a while, but watch. Oh, they film in the mirror. Well, girl, this is bootleg, so whatever. Okay, I like to wash my face with cold water. I'm not gonna cap, I stole that from Luca Savage because he was like, I wash my face with cold water because it just wakes me up. And then I tried it and I was like, dude, this goes hard.
I like cold water.
I like the feeling of cold on my face because a lot of times I'm tired,
And every time, cold wakes me up.
So here I am, hun. I don't even know. It's like 3 p.m. I washed my face earlier this morning, but I'm just doing it over because why not, hun? Why not, babe? Why not? Because I'm stuck in the middle with you. Hopefully this video isn't too long. I'm so sorry if it is. I'm going to try to make it 10 minutes at the least, 15 minutes at the most. So let's get through. Okay, so I got my LA colors. Yes, this is very much from like Dollar Tree or something. But hey, babe, it don't matter. You don't need all that $40 stuff at all. But I take the darkest color in there, which is going to be this really dark brown. And I kind of just, like, I like thin eyebrows. I've been into thin eyebrows for a while. I don't know what it is about them, but, like, you know how everybody has, like, an obsession with the early 2000s, like, today? Like, not today, but this day and age? Like, I'm one of those people, right? But I don't do it so much to where it's like, oh my gosh, my whole personality is, like, early 2000s per, you know, velour tracksuits, Juicy Couture, this, that, and the other. Like, that wasn't the only fucking side to the early 2000s. There was more. I don't know what more. I don't know exactly what they wore back then because I was only a little baby. But there's more. I know there's more. They didn't always wear on-brand stuff, babe. They didn't. It wasn't all about Dior and Lil whatever, you know? All right. With my eyebrows, I go in with a little foundation. Yes, this is lighter than my skin color. It's not mine. It's my mother's. Anyway, it's not like horribly light, but it is light to wear. Like initially when you put it on, it's like very much yellow because that's what skin color my mother is. And again, it's okay if you mess up. Look at me trying to be a beauty guru. It's okay if you mess up because, hun, we can just fix it. Like I said, oh wow, I look like those. Have you ever seen those people? Like the gel mug shots where the people have their eyebrows tattooed on. Like that's what this is reminding me of. I'm finna cry and then I'm not even going out. What the freak, dude? Yeah, I look exactly like the people who like take those. Oh wow. Oh, you look a little.
They ask you how you are, you just have to say that you're fine when you're not really fine, but you just can't get.
Are we still friends? I got to know. You know what? I wish people knew, like, okay, public service announcement, dude. 70s music is so hard. Like, okay, it just reminded me of this because Tyler, the Creator, samples, like, a lot of that stuff, right? And on his latest album, Igor, he did Dream by Al Green, the Ponderosa Twins, and a lot of other stuff, right? But, like, that stuff is so good. Like, those songs, amazing. Like, people who, sample those songs, you know, amazing. But the song, like, Alone is so good, bro. Like the original songs, like of the 70s and all that stuff, they be so good on their own. And, bro, it's just the vibe. Like,
that girl is pretty wild, no.
Don't blame it on sunshine. Don't blame it on moonlight. Don't blame it on good times.
It's starting now. It's the same feeling. I always seem to get a bump down.
So now my love to you, baby, I surrender. Get ready,
people be like, I shouldn't have born, what do you call it? I shouldn't have been born in this. Like, ugh, I hate people who listen to that stuff and be like, I should have been born in this generation. No, babe. It don't matter what generation you were born in. You just like old stuff. Like, LOL. It's okay to like old stuff. You're not in the wrong generation. Okay? Stop. But anyway, I'm gonna go to get dressed. This video is probably gonna be over 10 minutes, 15 minutes. But you know what? It's okay.
1, 2, 3 into the four. Snoop Doggy Dogg and Dr. Dre is at the dope. Ready to make an entrance, so whack on up.
Before I have to pull the strap off the cut.
Give me the microphone first so I can bust like a bubble.
Alright, kids, or people, or whoever's watching this, we're here. We're finna go in. We're finna style. See how my eyebrows... Actually, they don't look too bad. I'm actually very happy about that. Anyway, let's go! But anyway, girl, look at this sun. Can we look at this? Alright, so I went to CVS. That was for nothing. Because they didn't have nothing that I wanted. I mean, they did, but the line was like really long. And I was like, this isn't for me. Babe, I'm not trying to be here all day. So, and usually, I don't even know what's going on. Anyway, usually the line ain't even that long. So I don't know what the deal was. Today. But remember, when you come back, sanitize your hands. Anyway, I'm gonna go to Publix because I want some candy and some face masks. And I really hope this doesn't take long. but if it does, then look, it does, man. I really hope it don't, though. But let me get out of here.
Take a you don't want smoke, baby. Please believe me. Cause I'm in your oh.
This lady was watching me.
He'll never leave you and the rest of your crew. Cause I take out and I keep mine too. If you wanna fight, lace up. Oh. From the hood, lace up your shoes. If you too slow, can't keep up.
Okay, I don't know. I don't know what I thought was gonna happen, but I thought this was gonna be a little cute, quirky adventure for you and me to go on, right? And what did we end up getting, babe? Well, we ended up getting, hopefully ain't no COVID on this bag, but anyway, I ended up getting these because they're like my favorite thing in the whole wide world. Yeah, I wanted to get stuff for a smoothie, but I was just trying to get out of there. And then I got you fell. Are you okay? No, I'm playing, but listen. This setup is so trash. Alright, I got Jamaican cola. Okay, Jamaican soda in general is just a really good thing. My favorite is the pineapple. But they didn't have the pineapple in the little small glass bottles. They had it in a big jug. So, if you haven't tried Jamaican soda, Jamaican cola, Jamaican... anything, honestly, bro, you need to, because it's God sent from heaven. Hopefully this card is... anyway, y'all, I'm gonna go home. Y'all coming with me?
I don't know what you heard about me, but if you can't get a dollar out of me, no Cadillac, no...
Right, that trip was kind of underwhelming, I'm not gonna cap, but not underwhelming. It was a bust. That's what it was. And but it wasn't bad. I thought I was gonna ride my bike, but like I said, I couldn't reach my bike because of where it's at. And it's hot anyway. It's really hot and it's really humid anyway, so who's gonna do that? Not me. I thought I was gonna take a walk, but it's very hot and humid. So let's just say the final decision was not to do it at all. Decision was not to do it at all. But wherever you are, whatever time of day it is, I hope you're having a great day, a great week, great weekend, whatever. Whatever you're doing, I hope you're enjoying it.
You're looking at the future of the World Wrestling Federation. You're looking at the new World Heavyweight Champion. Let me repeat myself right there.
Wait.
I ain't repeating myself. Go ahead and tell me something right now. Yeah.
Wait a minute. You're telling me, Macho Man Randy Savage, that you're going to be the new heavyweight champion of the world? Don't you think Hulk Hogan's got a little to say about that?
Do you have something to say about it, Hulk Hogan? Do you have something to say to the Macho Man Randy Savage? Speak.